Hey YouTube, this is Dean making another vid. If you like my content, please consider hitting the like button. Also, please consider subscribing, as it is very much appreciated. Well, down the rabbit hole completely. This is my petrified wood. Almost the complete sampling I've got. And I've added two more pieces to my collection. Yeah, probably not going to buy too much more of it. These were quite good prices, and that's why I bought them. I wanted to show it completely. So this is the latest samples I've got from Chinchilla. That's a nice piece. Yeah, really, really nice piece of petrified wood. Wasn't too expensive either, only like $10 plus $10 in shipping. So yeah, quite cheap. Bought from a local bloke here in Australia. Yeah, it was only like a suburb away from me too, so yeah. I think they wanted to do slicing of them, but I'm going to keep them just as they are. These are samples, just like specimens for me. So yeah, this one definitely looks like the Chinchilla Red. It's got that red colour, so yeah, it's a fantastic piece. Sparks really well, but I'm not going to use it as a sparking stone. The other piece from Chinchilla, again, nice piece, nice sample as well. That mark there is just the surveyors, as they're going around picking it up, put it on there. So yeah, again, if you want to see it figured properly, you just wet that, and yeah, it comes up really nice, and polish it. So yeah, but again, I was going to break this one up, but yeah, I'm not going to. Yeah, I was going to use it as a sparking stone, but again, this one sparks really well too. That was that piece, the original piece I bought from Chinchilla. Yeah, really, it's probably the nicest piece I've got as far as like for display purposes. Like, it's been cut, it hasn't been polished as such, but yeah, it looks beautiful. It's a really nice piece. This piece is my granddad's. It's actually got a piece of opal running through it. It's opalized. You won't be able to see it, the camera won't pick it up, but there is an actual piece of opal running all the way through it there. But yeah, it's a really nice piece. Got a knot there. Really nice figured piece. He I'm pretty sure he picked that one up from, where was it now? Down south, when he was running around Australia. He was doing a trip around Australia, and he picked that one up. And then he also picked this one up off his old farm. It's another piece of really nice petrified wood. This is the Muckadilla stuff. I've got a fair few big pieces. Now, I do have a few pieces inside that I didn't bring out, that smaller pieces. But these are those pieces Dad gave me of the Muckadilla stuff. It looks very flint-like, eh, when you're breaking it up. It does look very flint-like. And this is probably some of the best sparking stone you can get. It's a fantastic pieces. That's the other piece there. You almost see the bark on that one there. That's on the outside. I'd love to get out to Muckadilla and actually get some more of this, but I don't know if we'll ever get out there. That's another piece. Then you can definitely see the bark on the outside there. Really nice piece, that one there. Then obviously my opalized piece there. That's my favourite piece out of all of it. All of them. Fantastic piece. My big piece of bark. She's a beauty, that one there too. It's a nice piece. I have to admit, I've really fallen for petrified wood. Yeah, and a big beauty out that there. Yeah, I've really fallen for it, but yeah, it can get very expensive if you start buying it for the bigger pieces. I've been looking on Etsy and that, you know, you can easily spend $1,000 on a big display piece, and especially for the opalized stuff. Which is what I like. It's the most colourful opalised or the agatised stuff. It can be hideously expensive and way outside my price range. But I do like this chinchilla stuff too. It seems to be very, very figured. And this red, the chinchilla red, is, it's fantastic. But, there are a lot. He's got the bloke I bought this off, he's got a lot more other pieces there, but how many do I need? I've got a fairly good sampling there now, so I don't think I need any more really. And it's just now for the love of it, just for display purposes. And this Muckadilla stuff too, if I could ever get back there, I'd probably fill the car up just for get a couple of nice display pieces, and then a couple of pieces I could break up for sparking, because it sparks so well. It's such like almost flint like as far as it goes. It's probably some of the best stone I've found for as far as it goes, and it's beautiful rock as well, you know, like as far as it, the looks of it as well, for petrified wood. But yeah, just wanted to show you a couple of new additions to it, and basically that's my whole collection except for a few small bits of the Muckadilla stuff. Anyway, thanks for watching.